Be me, B14. Recently started high school. Make enemies as easily as I make friends. Some midget child takes a particular disliking to me. Turns out he's a Jew. My Germanic heritage. Anyways.txt. Never owned an umbrella before. Have always used father's or brother's. Rains torrentially after school, drenching me. Take personal offense to this, and proceed to find the cheapest umbrella out there. Still own the umbrella to this day. Half a dollar and it isn't too shabby. Has some fake wood handle which looks nice despite its fakeness, and it's very compact. One of those flimsy, retractable ones. It deploys by powerful internal spring operation. Sidetracked again, .autism. Buy it. Turn up to school the next day. Short Juden is acting like he owns the place. I happen to be within range. Pulls out his slingshot, and by chance hits me in the head with a small steel BB. He is amused. Be not amused. Later that day in gym class, or whatever you want to call it, sitting on sideline a football match, waiting to play, when the ball flies through the air at Mach 0.86. And is going to hit some Anon in the face. The power of the umbrella enhances my reflexes, and I catch the ball on the collapsed canopy of the retractable umbrella, decelerating it to a stop and balancing it on one side like a ball on a bat. Silence as people try to figure out what just happened. What the fuck, .umbrella? Anon and I become friends. He is half Japanese. Go to changing room, and the Juden is noisily shit-talking. Other Jew tells him to shut the fuck up. Juden dismisses it and decides to start mocking my new friend's eyes. Axis powers intensify. Jump up onto one of the benches with umbrella in hand, challenging Juden to a duel. I have the high ground, .fag. Makes the mistake of saying, I lost the war. Dutchland. Dutchland Uber allies. Point umbrella at his face and press the release button. The umbrella impacts the center of his melon, and he is stunned, stumbling backwards into the concrete wall. The umbrella is now infamous. No further confrontation with Juden for a long time. Fat English friend of mine sits on the umbrella inadvertently. It is destroyed. There is widespread disappointment at the news of its demise. Return home. Assess the damage, and consider how much I enjoy fixing things. I accept the challenge. Rule 1, can only use parts which come off the umbrella to repair it, and one type of glue. Rule 2, no special tools, a hammer and pliers only. Rule 3, must be repaired of damage by the following day it was incurred. Tricky fix and some features were sacrificed, but I arrived at school the next day, triumphantly. Next day, umbrella meme intensifies. Umbrella is found by many students to be amusing. Umbrella is snatched from my grasp and used to beat someone over the head. Umbrella is destroyed in the process. News of its second demise circulates. Kid who got hit complains to the powers that be. Foreshadowtron fires up in the background. School assembly next day. Umbrellas now require a permit to say that they are safely designed and cannot be used as weapons or will be confiscated. George Orwell coughs loudly in the back row. I obtain my umbrella permit, and it is registered in the school's health and safety database. Fast forward 4 days. An unsolicited game of capture the umbrella breaks out, and the handle comes off, among other things. Obviously has been trodden on. Quickly gathered the pieces to conceal the damage, as I risk having my umbrella permit voided. Perform crude surgery on the umbrella for which I am starting to become a bit sentimental. Turn up next day with umbrella. No longer extends properly, and a locking pin is needed to secure it in the deployed position, but still works. Umbrella has become legendary, and students ask if they can hold it. Almost all the teachers who have no idea what is going on, and those who do, are believers in the umbrella's power. Fast forward 2 days. Umbrella is the victim of a hit-and-run attack. 4 seniors ambush me and take the umbrella. News gets out. And an all-out bonsai charge takes place, with half the junior school hunting down 4 seniors that took it. The operation was a failure. 1 week later, the umbrella is found in a roadside drain. Next day, a non-student kneels before me and returns the umbrella. ceremoniously. He is rewarded for his vigilance and honesty and slushy format. Umbrella is critically damaged, and the fabric canopy has almost completely come off, but I managed to repair it. Umbrella is now barely functional, but still, it continues to prove undefeatable, and my umbrella permit is still valid. Two minor inversions due to wind take place over the next week, and then the approaching summer no longer necessitates the presence of the umbrella. Decide to leave it at home for the duration of the summer, for the sake of preservation, despite many disciples of the umbrella trying to convince me otherwise. Fast forward 4 months. A freak rainstorm sparks fake news of the umbrella's second coming. The hype dies down after another 2 months, but a buzz slowly builds as the dry seasons draw to a close. Winter is coming. Cringe. Prophecy. The return of the umbrella after the school holidays. Cult grows over the 2 week break. Copycat umbrellers appear with other attempting to capture some of my umbrella's followers. My umbrella proves to be truly unique, and they uphold the ways of the one and only true umbrella.
Thou shalt have no other umbrellas before me.
1 week into the semester, my nemesis tries messing with me again, as he has grown resentful. Tries to get the school's history club, which is basically the Soviet Union club, to beat the shit out of me. They impolitely decline. Tries to get his older brother to beat the shit out of me on the football pitch during lunchtime in broad view of several teachers. He impolitely accepts. People notice the scenario, begin watching. He is the least coordinated person I've ever seen. Swings wildly at me and I don't even need to duck. Everyone is now watching intently. Two female teachers are frantically trying to arrive at the epicenter to break up the fight. One of them almost passing out from the exertion of a light jog. One male teacher is seen laughing his ass off as soon as the lunatic swings. Swift strike to the side of his head with the umbrella, which had slowly become lighter and more agile. He slips in the mud, surprised at the speed of the umbrella. Laugh track dot wave. About to be suspended for using a weapon despite it being in self-defense. Have idea. Pull out tattered umbrella permit and verify that it was deemed safe for the school. Did not count as a weapon. Charges dropped, and parents were told about the incident, but no punishment was issued. Juden brother claims he was just playing around and that it was a misunderstanding, thus avoiding his own punishment. Umbrella is now a mainstream meme in the school, and is almost confiscated on numerous occasions. Teachers are beginning to realize the power of the umbrella, and many seek to harness it. Half-Japanese friend now uses the umbrella for shading himself from the sun when I need someone else to carry it. Teachers can do nothing to take it from him, as it is used for his health and safety. Fast forward 4 weeks. Waiting for bus. A challenger appears. Juden Child deftly relieves me of the umbrella. Audible Titanic theme. A bus is pulling away from the stop. Some of the students on it see the traumatic event unfolding while the crowd at the stop looks on in shock. Juden Child thrusts the umbrella beneath the rear tires of the bus. There is a sickening crunch. He quickly gets into his getaway vehicle before chaos ensues, obviously having thoroughly planned the operation beforehand. There's a great sorrow, and mourners are gathering the carcass like respectful vultures. Juden Child has triumphed. Feels bad, man. Crowd parts to allow clear access. The damage is catastrophic. It has become two-dimensional. Metal trusses all squashed and shards of fake wood handle everywhere. Gather as much of it as remains as possible. Umbrella permit has definitely expired now. Get home. 1986 MacGyver theme plays at full volume in my head for 7 hours straight. Next day, enter the school gates, solemn. Umbrella is not seen on me, and word quickly spreads, confirming the worst. In school assembly, umbrellas are now banned due to health and safety incident, and a strict raincoat only policy is enforced, with a 1 day grace period to buy a raincoat. George Orwell blasts air horn from back row, screeching in newspeak. Must choose the perfect time. students leaving the assembly hall in a miserable state, with me leading the parade. Quickly, whip out the umbrella which I have been concealing inside my jacket for the past 4 hours. Raise it above my head for all to see. There is a collective scree from several hundred teenagers. Many are in disbelief. It was missing half of its parts, with around a third of the supporting arms, and could no longer extend forward at all, but it could open, close, keep me somewhat dry. It was good enough for the masses. It was still hope. Fearing confiscation, the umbrella is not seen again for some time. Parent of a really obese kid writes to the school complaining that no raincoats were large enough for the child. Said child could no longer wear a tarpaulin in the event of rain, as it was too embarrassing. Get contracted by the school dean to dispose of the umbrella under the supervision, make it a new one. Agree. Umbrellas are now unbanned, and George Orwell chills out for a second, wiping the froth from his mouth. Decide to form a secret society, and uniform them on the matter of extreme secrecy. Despite this, the KGB somehow finds out the details. Of course, .pdf. Dispose of the umbrella under the supervision of the dean after school. Heavy-handedly place it into the dumpster, and the dean closes it up, imagining this as the end of the ordeal. Some legend wearing a ski mask is sitting in the dumpster, waiting for it. And after around half a minute, some rummaging is heard inside. That face when they must have placed an operative in every single dumpster to ensure they captured the umbrella. Lid flings open with a tremendous crash, and the dean whirls around to see a kid in a mask clutching the umbrella, running away and screaming, "For the motherland!" trailing the flag of the USSR. Dean becomes the human manifestation of anger. Error 404, culprit not found. Peace treaty is signed with the commies, and the umbrella is gifted to the newly formed Secret Umbrella Society. But its location is only ever known by two people at any given time. The KGB proves very good at making sure nobody knows where it is, as I only see it for routine maintenance. It occasionally makes an appearance during lunchtime, which always causes a commotion. Fast forward 1 year. KGB has devised special procedures to ensure the protection of the umbrella. Umbrella must be exchanged for a special 50-cent coin every time it changes hands as a gesture of purchase for its original price. The 50-cent coin is marked, and it's circulated to the next operative that is chosen to keep the umbrella. Umbrella is back. Umbrella is codenamed 50 Cent. The teachers are kept highly confused due to our underground network of fake news sources, which makes identifying any suspect a nightmare. Question repeatedly on its location, but I give them nothing, saying I don't know where it is, and that I haven't seen it since it was stolen. Question on the Secret Umbrella Society. Imply that the notion of an underground network of students trying to conceal the location of a mangled umbrella because it's a meme in borderline cult is ridiculous, while appreciating the irony. Fast forward a few weeks. Umbrella is returned to me for maintenance by one of my assigned KGB contacts. Umbrella is seen in my possession by some CIA pig working for the teachers. Umbrella is confiscated from me after Dean shows up and gives me a lecture on discipline and honesty. There is a purge in the secret society after two double agents are exposed. KGB makes life difficult for them. Some assignments are misplaced and they lose friends. They move schools. Lone Wolf gets into trouble and reports to the KGB that the umbrella has been broken in two and is in the dean's office bin. KGB Anon Chick is on office notice, runner duty. KGB Anon Chick awaits for planned diversion. Dean is outside of their office, attending to a scuffle between KGB operatives. Umbrella is recovered just before the janitor empties the bin. KGB Anon's commended for their impeccable and professional planning. Small offcuts of the fabric canopy, which were removed during maintenance, are awarded to them as patches. Umbrella is returned to me to be repaired. Fast forward 2 days. News of the umbrella's confiscation and demise is confirmed, smugly, by the dean in the school assembly. Umbrella reappears in the school cafeteria during lunch break. His face went, dot what? Last weeks of winter, and weather seems to be almost clear. Umbrella has been broken many more times in transit, between operatives. but I have fixed it each time. It is in my possession of the 11th of August. It would be the darkest day in the history of the school. 8:11. Light drizzle begins while on the bus home from school. Think nothing of it. Get off the bus. Hail begins. Like marbles hitting my head, so I pull out the umbrella. This is the first known time it has been used to shield someone from the weather in months. Still works. Feels good, man. Tragedy strikes. Marbles begin to increase in size. Hailstone the size of tennis balls impact the top of the metal shaft, and the ball of ice shatters along with the entire umbrella. Wrist hurts like fuck. Some of the ice has gone down the back of my jacket. Feels disgruntled, man. Then it hits me like a hailstone should've. That moment when you realize that by sacrificing itself, the umbrella saved your life. Damage is so severe that the umbrella is now unrecognizable as having been an umbrella. And the only thing that could possibly kill the umbrella, after surviving years of abuse, is the very thing it designed to be able to handle. The weather. Irony. What the fuck? Reports of the final demise of the umbrella are slow to filter into the student's consciousness. Confirmed that the umbrella had been destroyed in saving me from almost certain death. Teachers all smug. Dean is smug. The society is in ruins. Someone tries to make a new umbrella by breaking one slightly and doing a real shit job of fixing it. It's not the same, and nobody follows. School morale is at an all-time low. Wailing, gnashing of teeth. Eventually, school life begins to move on, but there is still a void, which could only have been filled by the umbrella. Former society members in the KGB threaten to leak each other's identities as the treaty collapses into war of mutual assured detentions. Fast forward a lot to my last couple of weeks of high school. Find the mangled remains of what was once the umbrella down the side of my bed. Get chills. Maniacalgrin.kek. Fast forward 1 week. Last week of high school. The secret Umbrella Society is brought back together, and the peace treaty with the commies is reinstated. Worked harder on rebuilding the Umbrella than I did on any of my subjects that year. Last day. Worth it. Walk into final assembly, very late, through double doors, at the back of the hall, with the umbrella open and over my head. It's stitched together, and comprised of approximately 30% of the materials it was made from, and it's only semi-waterproof. But it still works. And it was back. Loudly hums some rap music from early 2000s. Everyone hears and turns around. Looks of disbelief. LOL what dot A LMAO. The look on the Juden manlet's face. The look on the dean's face. The look on my face. The final triumph. The umbrella is given a name on the last day. It is the genuine umbrella. It is an anorexic umbrella. It is almost a sun umbrella. It is the real Slim Shady. Guess who's back? Back again. Shady's back. Tell a friend.